Video editing can be a challenging but a rewarding task for anyone. And by using Optimize and Proxy Media, you can improve the efficiency of your edit workflow. It can significantly enhance your editing experience by reducing rendering time, improving playback, and optimizing your editing workflow. In this video, we'll cover everything you need to know about managing and creating Optimize and Proxy Media within Final Cut Pro. So let's dive into what Proxy and Optimize Media are and how they can benefit your editing workflow. What is Proxy Media? Proxy Media is a lower resolution version of your original video. To demonstrate that, I have two identical videos here. I have my original video that I shot with iPhone. I actually have an identical video that I have right alongside this. The original video is about 102 megabytes. Proxy version of that video is about 8.8 megabytes. In our original video, you can see that there is a lot of clarity. You can see the reflection here. And you can also see the texture of this metal box. In my proxy media, you are not able to see much detail. Now, this brings us to the question, what is optimized media? This is the optimized version of the original video, and this is about 927 megabytes. Under the hood, this has been converted into a format that Final Cut Pro will better understand. Now, let me guide you through the process of creating proxy and optimized media in Final Cut Pro. For this, I'm going to create a brand new event. I'm going to import some media from my hard drive. I'm going to change my view here to list view so it's easier for me to read the names and also demonstrate these options for you. Here I have three videos from different resources. The first one is the winding video that you've been actually watching. This was shot with my iPhone. Next, I have my Sony A7. That is the footage that I have actually recorded with my Sony A7. And then I have DJI. And when you click on your footage, you can see that there's a preview here. Also, you can see the original codecs. These are the codecs, or this is a piece of information that Final Cut Pro reads when you drag or import media into it. Here, I have this codec, which is from my Sony camera. And you can see as I'm scrubbing through it, it is struggling. Final Cut Pro is struggling to process this information. It will eventually read that information, but if you want to have a smooth editing experience, you need to have a codec that it actually reads. So what do we do in that case? So let me just start with winding video. I'm going to right click this video. I'm going to transcode this media. Let's create a proxy media first like this. I'm going to drag this here. What I can do is I can go ahead and perhaps make cuts that I want. Maybe I do not want this. I have just made a very rough draft or rough edit of this video, and you can see it's running really smoothly on my timeline. Now, this is what you are looking for when it comes to video editing. Let's go back to another video that we have, which is my DJI video that we have here. I can always convert this video if I want. Let's transcode this media. And maybe I want to convert this to optimized media as well. I can do that by clicking here. You can always go back in your settings and reveal in Finder, and it will actually show you where your media is situated. So now I have the original media, which is right now here, which is about 13 megabytes. Now, if I go into transcoded media and click on high quality, now high quality media would be optimized media. Now here you can see it's 56 megabytes. Now, if I were to go here and actually work on this video, it will work really, really smoothly. I will not have any problem. Let's go to Sony video that I have here. Now, let me just drop this video in my timeline. You can see that I am able to scrub, but it's not as smooth as what I was able to do with my DJI footage, which you can see here. I'm still able to scrub this, but it will take some time. But as my timeline gets complicated, this will become really hard to edit. In order to solve that, I can just right click this footage right now here and change it, transcode the media, and I can create either optimize or proxy media. Let's try to create both and see how it works. So now the video has been converted, and you can see that the proxy codec information is available here as well. When I come here and I change my options to proxy only, I am able to actually browse through it very easily, and I'm able to make cuts more efficiently, and I'm able to edit this timeline. Apple Apple has developed its own video formats that works really well inside Final Cut Pro, and these are industry standards now. Many cameras will come with these formats. When Final Cut Pro converts your videos into optimized media, it converts them into ProRes 422 format. Now, there are certain cameras that will record in ProRes. You may not need to convert your videos into proxy files. Those files will work natively on your Final Cut Pro editing software. Let me bring in the same file, which is converted into Apple ProRes proxy. Here you can see that this file already is Apple ProRes 422. Now this is a file that was originally shot in a different format, but then later converted into ProRes 422. And you can see how smooth it is when it comes to working inside my timeline. So I can bring it into my timeline. Now here you can see that it's running smoothly. Final Cut Pro does not have to do a lot of stuff to read this information. Optimize and proxy media will definitely take up a lot of storage. So you need to have larger hard drives. Perhaps that's the reason Apple charges a premium for all those computers that they are selling, where storage comes at a premium. You basically pay a lot more for storage than what you pay for a computer. Let me show you how you can manage your proxy and optimized media for an efficient editing workflow. As we discussed, proxy and optimized media can really improve the efficiency of your edit workflow. The downside of that is it can take up a lot of storage. In our example here, we have all the footage is stored inside our library location. Take a look at the size of our import and organize library. It's about 17.77 gigabytes. We are only working with 5 files that are very small to begin with. Now, this can get really large if you're working on a TV commercial or maybe a YouTube vlogs. They tend to have a lot of footage that you may not end up using, but you will need to import them into your Final Cut Pro library. If you're working on a short film, that can also have a lot of footage that you will be working on. You will be selecting a lot of footage, converting a lot of footage that will definitely take up a lot of storage on your hard drive. Now, it'll be great to actually move this footage to an external location. Let's click on Import and Organize. And I'm going to click on the inspector menu here. Now you will see a lot of options popping up. Once you click on import and organize, all this storage, all this media is located inside your Final Cut Pro library. Here is an option of media consolidation. So you can click on this. Now Final Cut Pro will ask you what you want to do with this media. What is it that you want to consolidate? Do you want to consolidate all this media into this location, media destination, which is our library, which is our library folder, or you want to choose a different location? Let's choose a different location. I'm going to go into my external hard drive and create a new folder here. I'm going to give it a random name, 0 file size, and I'm going to choose this as my folder. If I only want to choose original media, I will uncheck optimize and proxy media. But in this case, I want to take all the footage and move it to 0 file size folder that we just created. When I click on my external drive, 0 file size, that's the folder name that we gave it. We have our optimized media, which is right here. So you can see all of the optimized media has been moved to this folder. Also have my original media, and I also have my proxy media that you can see here. You can see the file size for our library is only 17.76 MB. What you could also do is, if you have a smaller storage external hard drive, you can always click on consolidate and only move proxy media to that external drive or any location that you actually choose. In conclusion, utilizing proxy and optimized media in your video edit workflow can help streamline the process and improve your efficiency. By following the steps outlined in this video, you will be able to create and manage proxy and optimized media inside of Final Cut Pro with ease. I hope you found this video helpful in your video editing journey. You can show your support by liking this video, and if you want to stay in touch and watch more videos for future updates, consider subscribing to the channel. Take good care of yourself. I'll see you in the next one.